Prepare for battle.
Is that really correct? Wait, hold on. I need to pull up F5 for a second. Right, with all the players under the correct heroes, and on the
battle begins.
As we just see an easy trade-off there. All right, I think that that's correct now. And then fly, MSS, is that right? Crit, Ritsu, Bulba, Arteezy, MG. Crit, Ritsu, Bulba, Arteezy, MG. Then fly, MSS, Moon, Yawar, and 747.
It shall not be.
Two. And I think that that's... We don't need to see the net worth graph. As Batrider ends up dying bottom lane, diving for Ritsu. Sorry about that one, missing the first blood, but actually wasn't first blood. That's some great editing speed there. Get out of here, Monolith. Get out of here. Fake Charlie is right. This is actually such a difficult matchup. 9 stacks of Fury Swipes. So if he hits him, that does so much damage. It's really rough. This is the cool thing about playing Ursa nowadays, though, is that, like, because of the change he ended up getting with Fury Swipes, where it sticks and resets for 20 seconds, you actually are just able to completely destroy other mid-matchups, rolling in, trying to find the kill, but doesn't look like they're going to be able to do it. Batrider, meanwhile, on the bottom lane, was able to kill off Morphling. He's going to lose his life, so I thought there were going to be a kill there, but instead, it's a kill bottom. The Chich still looking for it. They do find the kill. So 2 for 2 already. Meanwhile, Bulba just trying to battle out with Yuar. Why is the text bigger on the right? Because of an oversight. 747 listed back, trying to find the crit. Oh, God, he's so low! 747, 20 HP, but they can't find it. My God, he does so much damage already and does have another nuke in 4 seconds. He might just be able to kill off MSS. He has another roll as well as the stun. Kicks him away. Get out of here, he says. Well played. Oh my God, that was really close. This game is already off to a frenetic pace, and it looks like DK is just going to deny himself. So he ends up being able to get out of that one fairly okay. Nicely done. But yeah, you can see, left alone at least for the moment, top lane, the Anti-Mage has really been able to have his own, while Ritsu has been somewhat hurt in terms of his farming rate. That being said, you still got Arteezy getting a nice little chunk of it here in the mid lane. He's battling up against the Dragon Knight. Oh my God, that damage. It's actually kind of a rough matchup. Meanwhile, Moon pulled back for the moment, Sunray still on him. Need to be somewhat careful against this. They have another nuke now and a little bit more damage being leveled against them. There's the Icarus dive forward, and Ritsu might be able to find that kill. They do end up bringing him down and the Phoenix, so 1-for-1 exchange. Still no big deal as of yet. God, Ritsu is so close to dying here. He does still have 12 wand charges, so probably wouldn't end up being an easy kill. Good stuff. Out about it. Okay, meanwhile, bottom lane, more battling going. The Batrider not able to get to the deny range with those neutrals. MSS still taking damage on the Earth Spirit. I haven't seen him play this for a little while. Ritsu dives deep for it and finds the kill. It's going to take a couple of shots on his way out the back from that tower. But he should still be fine. The Tango's going to provide him so much regen there with the being able to switch it off. And also the laser comes in as well. Sorry about that for the in-game sounds. Had to bring it a little. I think that should be good there. I was alt-tapped for the moment to make sure that the stream looks good. Alright. Bulba, he's been able to get himself level 5. The in-game sounds are still going, right? It's still working? They should all be there. Can you guys not hear him? Grant just rage quitted? What the fuck? Uh-oh. That's no good. Alright. We're good to go. We got 747 battling it out here against Arteezy. Take a look at the CS marks, and it's having a pretty good time with this Ursa in the mid lane. They've got a couple of heroes that are roaming around, seeing if they can find any type of kill, but no great luck. Meanwhile, Moon still battling it out with Ritsu on the bottom lane. I mean, you take a look at the CS battle right now, and the Morphling being harried in the whole time by this Batrider, it's really led to this Anti-Mage just having a great time in comparison. I mean, he's already up to being able to, I mean, finish off his treads as well as the, you know, Ring of Health up and online. This is going to be a tough Anti-Mage to deal with in the later stages. Meanwhile, Crit with the DD rune is going to rotate in now and maybe capable of finding Moon, his teammate, but they don't end up trying to pursue that. It's been a bit of a rough one. You gotta love these in-house leagues, though. You see teammates that are playing against each other and how they sort of think about the game in general. MSS and Fly moving towards the mid lane, but already away, they're not going to be able to find anything here. Asurus is heading back and is just going to jungle for a moment, not seeing anybody on the map. And there's actually just four heroes mid for this. Batrider is going to head off to the jungle to try and stack up camps as well as get some gold for himself. But at least for now, they're looking to see if they can find anybody, and no great luck. I think that Miracle is taking a break out of this game. They dropped out a deep ward at the very least, and with that, I think that they're just waiting to see if anybody heads back out. But we'll see which way the big bad bear wants to go. He's going to head back home. So again, playing it very, very safe at this point. They haven't seen the supports for a while, realizing that they're missing. They head on out of there. So pretty good recognition. MSS and Fly are kind of just stuck here, not really doing a lot. So good in-game awareness, and looks like with that, the Tier 1 tower is probably going to fall. So maybe they end up trying to push a lane of their own, but it's a little bit scary to actually do that. MG, Artur, going to head out. Meanwhile, Bulba is here in the middle lane. They do have a Chronosphere available, but I don't know if they're actually going to be able to find it. Yeah, they do end up being able to get that kill. MSS still getting peed on for a moment by that Phoenix, a lot of damage being leveled 747's way, and he is going to drop. So a nice kill there comes after the rotation. They did end up losing that void, unfortunately, but not the worst thing in the world.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Bottom lane. Level 6 Morphling. Trying to build into the Lincoln Sphere for himself. Wants to stay safe against that Batrider eventually, but I do get the feeling that this is going to end up being the Batrider going for the drums, trying to hold that tower for as long as possible. Meanwhile, Crit with the Urn up and online. You should be pretty comfortable just sitting back here and waiting for somebody to TP in to defend the tower. MSS can't hang out down here any longer, so they're going to have to rotate in several heroes if they want to try and come and contest if they push this tower at all. Looks like he actually does just back out. And the drums are finished now. TP comes in. They have lift available. Flame Break hits onto one, but I don't think Ritsu cares that much. Yeah, he just backs out. Mid lane, rotation is here, trying to mess with Arteezy a little bit at least. There's the Dragon Tail, but doing very little damage to him. The turnaround here on the bottom lane, he might have overextended. There's the waveform forward, and he just goes down. Like, even though he got the drums right there, normally you would try and be able to hold the tower. I guess that just not getting his wand charge, stick charges off before the lift came from the Rubick, and that ends up hurting him. It would have been okay if he would have just gotten those stick charges off, but not in time. Meanwhile, Yuar, level 8. It's his 10,000th game of NEL. Can I please paste again the players? The players are all right on top of the screen. You should be able to see them. Alright, here comes a big rotation in. Bulba ends up getting silenced. They need to keep him alive. Another silence there onto MG, and things getting a little bit messy now. They do throw in another really good Earth Spike, but I think Yuar is finally going to fall. They might be able to run down Fly here, the time dilation, keeping him controlled for the moment, but I think that with that, they're not going to be able to find anything else. Alright. Okay. Well, that's going to be that. And I think that with this, they should trade out towers again one for one. MSS is still here, so if they want to try and come back and contest the bottom tier one tower, he could probably break a couple TPs. But not being level six, I doubt they can really try and fight this. He needs to be a little bit careful. MSS... Shazam, you do not want to get caught there. And yeah, they're going to be able to get this tower. It's down. Down for the count. And it looks like we're going to be good. Moon trying to take these camps now. Having already completed the drums, he's fairly tanky. Hard to bring down, but he still needs some of that catch. The big thing and the reason that people do this, by the way, is that oftentimes, by the time the back gets a Blink Dagger, it's not really going to matter all that much because you can't really jump in and pull somebody out and then burst them anyways. So what you end up doing is just sort of maintaining lane dominance, make sure that in the midst of a team fight, you can get a couple hits and you can pop drum charges and still move very rapidly. But now that Lion has his finger up and online, I feel like you can probably go for the Blink now on Batrider because you're going to be able to immediately go for like a big instant kill afterwards. So it's probably going to be a decent position. This would be the moment where they would like to be able to have a Bat Blink Dagger online. They jump in onto 747, a lot of damage being leveled against him, still alive for the moment. Finger of Death onto Crit, he is going to die there. And meanwhile, the Dragonite is also gone, double magnetized. He's actually able to survive through that. That was really close to Arteezy being able to find that kill. The Sunray still going, but not hitting onto too many. The waveform goes in, is going to be able to kill off Shazam. MSS, Ritsu switching to waveform for the moment, does still have Replicate available if he wants to go for it and get out of there, but it looks like he's trying to dive for a big play here and not going to be able to find it. He gets out, they're good to go. Oh no, he might have overextended slightly. He knows where he is. Waveform, he doesn't have the mana for it. Oh no, this was not meant to be. All right, good decision making there to back out. That could have gone terribly awry if he stuck around a little bit too much longer. Holy hell. That was really close. Alright, let's take a look at where we're at right now in the game. Relatively even in terms of net worth and experience earned. The big difference maker right now is that you have these sort of three cores that are up and online, whereas the Radiant are kind of getting four. Like, Crit is incredibly farmed right now for Rubick. Granted, one of that is the urn, and then the other part is the Arcane Boots. So it's not like a blink dagger at this point for a Rubik, which is just absurdly strong. But you look at them, and they're not that significantly further behind than the Batrider. Granted, the Batrider did just get an influx of about 700 to 1,000 gold from taking that stack, and it's going to be able to get his blink dagger online soon. So there's going to be this moment until Moon gets his blink dagger where they're kind of on equitable levels of farm, and I think given that, the Radiant might want to try and pressure to make something happen here. There's the jump board on the fly. He gets Hex for the moment. Arteezy's still thinking about diving deep for this one. And can pop his ultimate. Actually, he's in trouble now. He's being pulled away. And, oh, God, he needs that 80% damage reduction. He's able to get it off and might even be able to turn this one back around if he has the damage. But he ends up getting kited to death and brought down. That was a really good play right there from the Rubik. If Earth Spirit was able to get off his silence, then you don't get the ulti coming out from the Ursa, and they wouldn't have been able to get that damage reduction, but unfortunately it still wasn't enough in the end as he was brought down. So close, real close. That would have been good if they could have found it, but unfortunately no such luck. MG trying to run away, hasted, and is going to be out of there. And yeah, now Moon, as soon as he gets this blink dagger, this is a huge power curve for the Dire. Meanwhile, mid lane, though, they're going to roll in, kill off crit. He goes down. Chronosphere dropped on MSS and 747, but MG walked into the midst of it and ends up dropping down the Supernova. That should maybe be enough to find the kill. Doesn't Arma toggle? Bulba going to go down. They get the heal. He's just going to be able to run away. 73 HP. Oh, all he needed was one more right click, and it would have been enough. But no such luck. Oh man, if the Supernova could have gone off previously, if he had not been caught in that Chronosphere, that would have been really, really good. I'm not sure if he walked into it or got hit by it, but regardless, a little bit unfortunate. Alright, what are we looking at? Still Blink Dagger online for the Ursa, so that's pretty solid there. And Bulba himself might be building back into the Vlads later. Wouldn't mind to see something cool, a Blink Dagger of his own. I mean, you look at some of these other items that they got on the Radiant side, and you've got a lot of ability to keep up with people, a lot of movement coming in. We'll see where it ends up translating them towards. Rubik actually has 1,100 gold. If crit saves up for a Rubik, like, this is a great game for a Rubik to be in there. And they've already actually got Blink, so maybe, I wonder if he just, like, ostensibly, crit could go Ags, like, first item. I don't know if that would completely be worth it, but it could be. Like, he's incredibly mobile already. Alright. Meanwhile, Roshan is gonna start to go down. Maybe he just does still stay with Blink. Force Staff is another decent item. If you're having trouble with, you know, Ursa getting kited a little bit, then you can run it that way. But Aegis is up and online now for Mr. Ursa. And this is starting to look like one of those moments where they're just going to kind of be able to roll a little bit. It's interesting because you've got like the early damage and aggression that comes out from an Ursa, but also that late game carry capability that you get out of a Morphling. So these things are working pretty well. It is going to be the Vlads for the Faceless Void. Ends up going the Iron Talon a little bit earlier too, which we didn't talk about a ton, but it seems like that's working for them. I guess the Earth Spirit is pretty equal on farm to what the Rubik has also, though. Well, it's a little bit back and forth, but looking to maybe be a four-person smoke. Seeing if they can use this Aegis now. As far as damage is concerned, they've got a decent chunk of it. Oh, and they spot out that there's one up there. Ping's going off this direction, realizing exactly where the enemy team is. Maybe they're just going to try and bait this out, see if they can get a reaction. Place the ward from the low ground. I wouldn't mind Aether Lens, too, on the Rubik. Bulba. Ping's out there in the area over here. They're smoked up. Does he end up being able to find them? They jump forward with crit. Oh god, if he had a blink dagger right now, this would be huge. Looking for the catch. He jumps in. Arteezy is there, and there's going to be the Chronosphere catches on to three. There's not a lot of follow-up damage right now, but they should be able to get it, and there's going to be the Hex for the moment. Steals that one away. Moon as well. Oh, it's beautiful. A triple right there. Caught in the Chronosphere, and Ritsu gets away with a double. Exceptionally well played. And crit set that up, breaking the smoke by blinking over into this area behind the trees. They didn't have vision of who was there. And then following it up, the jump in by Arteezy keeps them busy for the moment. That was awesome. That was very, very well played. Dire's bottom tower has fallen. Tomato loves it. That chrono was so good. Alright, 747. I'm assuming this is going to be Shadowblade for him. It's a pretty good game for... Well, it's an okay game for Silver Edge. I mean, the damage reduction is always relevant. That's super good. By the way, Rubick has 2,000 gold. Yeah, I think he's going blank. Damn. This is definitely going to be one of those games where Rubick is going to be doing a lot. I mean, there's so many great spells to steal, honestly. I mean, you start to think about, for instance, like Anti-Mage. The damage reduction is really relevant. Moon, hanging out here. Arteezy runs into him. Hey, how you guys go, guys? He's going to try and chase down Moon. Blink Dagger off cooldown in 4, but it's not going to be able to find anything. And yeah, that's a Blink Dagger for crit. (clears throat) 747 gets a catch there onto Bulbaritzu, doing a lot of damage on the fly. Hex for the moment. Crit pulls him back. He's going to be able to get the stun onto Yawar. But I think that they're going to have to call it good there. Bulba already dead. Ritzy now switching over to Strength Form, taking a lot of damage from Yawar. And that might end up being a kill. The Mana Blade is not actually going to be able to get it, as the Lincolns popped it. But regardless, they end up being able to take down that Morphling. And that's a pretty significant kill. I mean, 1900 gold. More importantly, that's more time for your Anti-Mage to continue to try and build a little bit of dominance in terms of his farming rate. Yawar is certainly going to be happy with that one. They're doing it. They're making it happen. Dota 2, ladies and gents. Curious if this is a game for Ursa Ags. I wouldn't hate it. It'd be pretty solid. I mean, he could also just go straight BKB, but there's a lot of... Well, there's two things that mess with BKB, although really Mana Void is not super impactful. Oh, he goes Basher. Okay. Do you. 747, bottom lane. They're looking. Crit has Finger of Death. Oh my god. I didn't realize he stole that. That's pretty solid. Moo Dota 2, what's up, man? Oh, Arteezy chasing down 747, and not going to be able to find anything there.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
There we go. He's hooked up. Jump forward, lift back on the bat. Moon is going to end up getting the Chronosphere dropped on his head. A couple quick hits, and that might end up being just another kill going the way of the Radiant squad. They're starting to run away with this one a little bit. I mean, you look at the net worth. It's granted starting to swing back a little bit more into the favor of the Dire, but I don't know. It's a tough one. That one big kill in the middle was huge. Arteezy got himself a little bit of a basher. Good stuff. Oh, we'll see if they're going to actually find somebody here. I don't think that this is an easy kill on Arteezy. They actually run right underneath the Sentry Ward, and that's going to be a jump. Crit Finger dead. He's going to run away for the moment, I'm going to assume. He's stealing another spell in a second, but 747 goes down. And unfortunately, it was underneath that Sentry Ward when that came about. And now you've also got a Blink Dagger up and online for Void. I mean, the kill there in the mid lane on that Morphling was super solid, but I don't know. Just 6 giant Empire. Oh, Moo, I'm sorry. Can I watch this on Feb, March, or April tickets? I don't know, actually. As far as I'm aware, each of the games get individually hosted on whatever ticket people happen to have. So, I don't think so. Yeah, Moo, it's been a... That's a bit of a rough one. There is no English production on the scene, as far as I'm aware. At least as of yet. It could be a little bit rough. Nanyang's going to be a very interesting tournament to watch. I believe it's going to be wonderful. All right. Meanwhile, bottom lane, they spot out that he's there as the scan finishes. Waveform forward. That should be a kill on all his man-style illusions. I mean, you compare right now the amount of farm that they've been able to get on this Rubick in comparison to how stuck Fly has been here. He still doesn't have that blink up and online. Well, as far as the state of the game is concerned, about 1,000 gold lead into the favor of the Radiant. The Dire's a little bit ahead in terms of experience, but it does look like they're going to jump now and are going to be able to catch on to Moon. Chronosphere drop. They might actually just be able to do this. A lot of damage being inflicted. Dragontail not thrown down as of yet. It does look like Ilara is going to end up jumping on it. Crit needs to be careful. Might get brought down, but still stunned up for the moment. Artesia in the midst of all of it, taking a good amount of damage. Finger of Death comes out, and they are going to be able to find that kill. Blinks out for the moment. Crit trying to get out of here, but is in a lot of trouble. Well, it looks like they think that he's TP'd out, but he certainly did not. He's still in there. So well played. That was really close to being a kill. Oh, man. All right, tier 2 tower bottom starting to take a little bit of fire here. And it looks like, at least for now, that should be pretty good. You are 747 MSS on the bottom lane, doing work on that tower. Oh man. Morphling building towards that Mantis style should have it relatively shortly. Medusa also have Yuar. He realizes his ancients are getting stolen. Get out of my house. Don't want none of your shenanigans. Lion does have his blink dagger now. What else are we missing in this game? I haven't really seen a ton of progression as far as items are concerned. Like, there's just a lot of blink daggers all over the map. A couple of other mobility items, the DK with the Shadow Blade, all fine and dandy. He has 2,600 gold in the bank too. I think about going in on this, the replicant, scouting things out. They're waiting to jump on it. Oh, 747, you gotta be careful, bud. I think he's gonna be able to get out of there though. Realizing that nobody's showing on the map, they're probably coming to try and kill me. That's the best guess. Jump forward, catch there for the moment, moon down, and dead. Middle lane, Ritsu not really afraid of anybody. He heads out the other direction. Thanks for the stream, Grand Grant. Is 200 by 100 resolution. I'm sorry, guys. Oh my god, thank you, Mollicast. I need to work out my subscriber things. I don't have any of my... I really want to hear the rundown of the quality of life of Moo's hotel room. I'm very curious about this. But yeah, Mollicast, thank you for subscribing. I haven't set up any of my stuff. I literally just got subscribers, like, very recently. Okay, crit. Blood damage. They drop the chrono onto 2. 747 and you are a pretty good couple of heroes to catch, but they just don't have the damage to follow it up. Arteezy is in the Roche pit trying to take him down. Fly is going to die on the other side. The supernova's coming out as well, and 747 might actually go down. That replicant damage from the anti-mage illusion, that was so good. And now they should be able to go into the Roshan pit uncontested. That was actually really solid. Moon pulls back up on Arteezy already. A pretty nice advantage for the Radiant. Can they pull it back now and try and make something happen? There's the adaptive strike from afar. MG finds the kill. MSS drops down another one of his... Oh, might be able to find the kill onto him. Trying to TP out, but he's definitely dead. So they did manage to get the ultimate drop from the Earth Spirit, but it was only enough to kill a Phoenix. And now you're still in this awkward situation where you are going to end up losing Roshan. Like, fight recap, there was already a 1,700 gold swing into their favor. They had to come and contest it already so far behind. And now Yuar controlled for the moment. I don't think they can actually kill him. but they can make his life a little bit tough. So the Dire just desperately trying to hold on. They know Phantom giving up the potion would be really terrible. Crit is going to get taken out. So Yawar making the best of a bad situation. He's going to run in with his illusions. Can go for the steal potentially. Jumps onto Ritsu. Aegis is going to be picked up now by Arteezy. Needs to get a bash onto Yawar. Not there as of yet. The Earthspike comes through, and that's actually a jump on the bottom lane. Ursa still has the Aegis intact if they want to go for it. 747 coming in, trying to be able to jump onto Arteezy, but just does not have the vision. There's going to be the Aegis popped, and now they have the follow-up stun. Probably going to hit him once with the Shadow Blade and then follow it up afterwards with the Dragon Tail. There it is. He's dropped down. So despite the fact that that fight started pretty terribly, it ends up working out into their favor. Well played there by the Dire. Tenacity, stick-to-itiveness, whatever you want to call it, they make it work for them. Played. Holy hell. Oh, my goodness. That was really well played there. And again, this game is just super close. And I'm not exactly sure, like, who carries harder. I feel like Rubick late game, once he starts getting... I mean, he's already got a good amount of farm. And now he can, if he wants, go back for, like, a 4-staff or build into, you know, potentially... I don't know. Probably not something like a Yule Scepter. It wouldn't be the worst thing in the world, Batrider. Is he gonna have a BKB anytime soon? Probably not. So that's one way that you could counter the... you know, jump in, force away by bat if you got quick enough fingers. But Rubick already has lift back, so it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. He could also just go, like, straight Ags, which I wouldn't hate either. But I feel like more mobility items allowing him to get away from Yawar if he jumps on top of him. And it is a problem. Like, they've already got the heart down. Fly is going to be controlled for the moment in that Chronosphere. The pullback by Moon got forced that forward and actually maybe is going to be able to kill off all the Supernova in the midst of three of them. There's the jump forward. 747 taking a lot of damage. Yawar is here, but I don't know if he can actually find the kill. Tried to Manta Dodge away from that damage, but it's not going to end up being able to work. The Icarus dive away. Jump forward. Moon trying to take down Phoenix, but Arteezy is there. He's pissed off. A couple quick hits and they bring him down. Nicely played. 4-for-2 exchange already in a really good team fight right there. These illusions coming in from the anti-mage are really messing with MG. So good decision making there. Yawar still does not end up being able to completely carry it, but you can see that this is becoming a problem. It is definitely a rough one. And 20k net worth on him. I mean... I don't know, it's starting to get scary, that's for sure. He's got a Basher now, going to be building into an Abyssal soon as well, I would imagine. Like, they do have answers, certainly, and you're going to be building into more of those answers as the game goes on. You've got this Basher already up for Ursa, and I'm assuming he's going to be going back after his BKB into the full Abyssal Blade. They also have the Rubick, who's got that instant, you know, jump in, disable type of thing going on. Oh, they might run into each other here. A little bit of a, hey, how you doing in the woods? Arteezy needs to get out of there. 10,000 net worth behind him. It is going to be a 4-staff for the Rubick eventually. Was that a 30-minute Midas? MG picking it up. Hey, man, you got to do what you got to do. He wants to get those extra levels. He's actually almost level 16 anyways. I don't know if it really matters all that much. All right, they pull back Yawar for the moment, but that was just to steal a little bit of a blink. What is green? Is that just anti-mage? I'm just showing on my map a little bit weird. They pull back onto the Phoenix. If he can get Supernova off, this will be pretty good. They do end up being able to get the Chronosphere onto three. Not a ton of damage, but they kill off one. Earthspear already dead. Phoenix is going to go down as well. He wasn't able to get off Supernova in time. Moon drops to Arteezy, trying to kill off 747, and that should be a kill. Pops BKB, turns onto Yawar, punches him in the gut one time, and now he might be able to find this. Needs to get a bash, but not going to be able to find it as of yet. Yawar still going, and they end up being able to interrupt the Mana Void another time through, and a couple more shots. The Lincoln Sphere still keeping Ritsu at bay for the moment. Fly blinks away, should be out of there, and I think that they're not going to be able to catch up to Yawar. Still has his heart regeneration as well to deal with, so very, very well played to get out of that exchange. You can still see, though, that he just doesn't have the damage where they have to worry about him as of yet. If he's able to stick onto a target for an extended period of time, the anti-mage does a lot, but just not nearly enough. We'll see. It's just a tough game. And honestly, you've still got to deal with the Morphling, too. like, I'm struggling to see how they win this, because one of the ways you can do it with anti-mage is obviously like pushing down a lane, then just taking out a lane of barracks. But outside of him, heroes that are capable of like pushing a lane and not having to worry about dying, there aren't many of them. With the E-Blade now up on the Morphling, like Moon can't do that safely in a lane. Earth Spirit not really either, and he's not the greatest at pushing the lanes anyways. DK probably can, but it's starting to get to the point where even he has to be at least a little bit worried about what's going to happen. Alright, well, let's take a look at any other items that have been picked up that we might have missed in the midst of the broadcast. We've still got a good amount of gold on several of these people, I believe. Do we have any, what's the current gold? 2,000 is the highest on that void, so I'm assuming he's going to be going back for Mantis style now. Yeah, this is, they're going to start transitioning the other damage on these other cores, and like I was saying, you've got crit that's so farmed. Like for this Rubick at this point in the game, he's above the Batrider. That is a rough life. Glad you guys have been enjoying the broadcast so far. I'm probably going to stick around for a little bit longer. I might take a short break, but I'm probably going to hop into the broadcast and just miss out on the first part of the drafting phase for the next game. And then later on tonight, we'll still have to see what's happening. But there's a chance I might try and cast Nanyang. I think that if it ends up happening at a decent time, then I might try and go do the Yan-Yan cast. They get the BKB off on 747. Bulba's in the midst of all of them. Moon took a lot of damage, but not dead yet. They throw out the Bulbic Silence, but Arteezy controlled. There's the Finger of Death. They find the kill. Grit does what he needs to. That stolen Finger of Death, pretty huge. They're trying to control him and kill him off, and they are going to be able to find it. Arteezy still going after 747. Gem on the ground. Yuar is trying to deal the damage to Arteezy, and is still getting kited around slightly, in a little bit of trouble. Bulba, oh god, there's the hit. There's the bash. That's going to be another dead hero. Ritsu now going down as well. That's going to be another one. Four dead. And the only one left alive, at least for the moment, is Arteezy hobbling away. And now you get into a situation where they take a team fight near the enemy base. This is really hard to contend with. They've got buybacks on these heroes, but you don't want to have to use them. And Yuar starting to hit away there on the tier 3 towers. There's going to be the ultimate coming out from the Dragonite starting to wear off, but they don't have a Chronosphere for another 40 seconds. I don't know how they defend this. Like, buyback status, there's nobody that really is going to be able to buyback that's going to make a huge difference. Crit's going to be back up relatively shortly, but they take the melee barracks and they're going to back. They go down towards the bottom lane. Yuar continuing to hit away, soaking up the damage from the tower. Down here is going to be Moon continuing to hit that. Oh, and push out the lane. 747 controlled, but still fine for the moment. Yuar killed off the Rubick. He has buyback, though. Now Arteezy trying to hit away, but he just can't do enough damage to that anti-mage. He's got so much net worth at this stage. Yuar doing what he needs to do. And he is a scary beast. My goodness. Well, OG Moon. It's still a bit of a tough one. Hasn't had the easiest of games. There's a lot of ways to mess up what he's trying to do. Morphling still is something that's not really to be trifled with. He's starting to get the farm levels up and can do a lot late game to that anti-mage. It's just a question of if they're actually capable of making it work. This is going to be a five-person smoke. They are going to move in, check out Roshan. It is going to respawn relatively shortly. But as for now, at least, they are going to miss it just by a few seconds. They might just wait for it, honestly. He's enraged. He's overpowered. Are they just going to wait for it? This isn't the worst idea in the world. The smoke also could break, and then they'll be able to jump onto somebody. This is actually kind of cool. I like this. They drop the vial. Cool. Good stuff there. And yeah, they just waited for Roche. Okay. Pings come out. They need to be careful. Yawar is there. Fly could jump in if he wants. Looking for an Earth Spike, possibly. They end up being able to spot them. They drop the Colossus here. Only hits on the 747, and Yawar is also doing a lot of damage. They catch their MG, taking a lot. The stun, follow it up. Arteezy up on the cliff now. He's in a lot of trouble. They get the Supernova down. He's not going to be able to do any damage in the midst of the fight. Yawar just going to town on the Bulba. Doesn't end up being able to find it as of yet. Moon controlled and should be killed off for the moment. Ritsu, waveform forward, is going to be able to find Fly. That's three dead now. Yawar is still alive, but they're going to buy back. They want to come and try and contest Roshan. Other heroes with buyback are all Radiant side, so this is going to be it. No Dragon Knight, no Batrider for this fight. But it looks like, at least for now, the Radiant not super... Oh, okay, Yawar needs to be a little bit careful on the backline. MSS hits three with the boulder smash as well as the silence, but Yawar is going to end up dying. Arteezy is on a killing spree, and it looks like Roshan is going to be next. That's three dead now, and this could potentially be it. Oh no, new game hosted. We're not in Dota TV, so I think that some people just feel like the game might be over, but it's not as of yet. It's pretty close, and keep in mind the whole time that was happening, they ended up being able to take this other lane of barracks, so at least the ranged one went down. My goodness. Net worth lead, 7,500 with right about the same amount of experience. Oh. Oh, you know what? You're right. That was time dilation. Holy hell, that was great. $2,500 gold on this Phoenix. We've been seeing a lot of Phoenix Ags come up. I wouldn't mind that. It'd be pretty solid. Looks like it's going to be a butterfly for Ursa. Nice. You love to see that. Mantle on the Void up and online. Rubik is going to be going back for a Lotus Orb, it looks like. We also got a butterfly on Anti-Mage. But if you thought about the way that that fight happened last time, a lot of the damage that came out actually was just by virtue of the Phoenix. The Supernova and, oh, Sunray, really. I mean, you look at it, it's still a ridiculous amount of damage that comes out. 5% damage as a percentage of your current HP is so absurd. And against a hero that's now very tanky like this Anti-Mage, it's very difficult to deal with it. If you think about it, if he's got 3,400 HP, that means that he ends up taking 170 damage per second, just as a portion of his, as a portion of the damage from Sunray per second. Like, that's so much damage. And this is really why they need that Earth Spirit to be there to be able to break that Sunray when it ends up coming about. Now Ursa level 20, got crit, still sticking around. And it looks like, at least for the moment, everybody not really wanting to push their luck too much. I mean, you've got Aegis on Ursa, so you could ostensibly go for some type of a play, but it's a little bit tough. Ritsu, tier 2 tower, going to fall. Looks like that's going to end up going their way, so nicely played there. Moon, blink force, looking for it, but not finding it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Now, it looks like Arteezy is just going to be sitting comfortably with what he's got. I'm a little bit surprised that they're not trying to do something with the Aegis, but maybe they just feel comfortable going late game and it's a way to try and stall it out longer against this Dire squad. I've been noticing that these NEL games have been going longer and longer and not really all that concerned with trying to just push the tempo super quickly. Looks like a four-person smoke now coming out from the Radiant. Oh God. A little bit of lag here. Don't worry, it's fine. I promise everything's gonna be good. 747 revealed, looking for the jump. They get the couple quick hits onto him and is gonna be able to bring him low. That is gonna be a kill going their way. And with that, I think that the Radiant, or rather the Dire, need to back off. But yeah, Ursa ends up trying to go in for the play, and they end up being able to find it with crit jumping in. Nicely done. Dropping some frames. Holy hell. I haven't, and I don't know anything. Oh my god, that's a lot of frames that are dropping. What is happening? Holy shit. Occasionally, this is just something that's happening. All right, we're back. We're back. I think we're good. We're good. Okay, we're back. I don't know anything about the casters flying out to China or anything like that. I haven't heard anything. Lotus Orb. Refresh. Should be back now. They're with stuff going on with Twitch recently, where suddenly I just drop out. I might need to switch to Ingest or something. You are not jumped upon as of yet. They just throw out a little bit of a sun ray, make them scared, and they back out. Yeah, I don't know if it's Twitch or if it's me or what exactly it is, but there's been a couple of little issues from time to time with the streams just having trouble. But it seems like it's a little bit better. I hope. Would not be the best if it started having trouble again right now. Any other big items up and online? Phoenix is going to be going for that Aghanim Scepter and actually has it right now if they want to go for it, but definitely more worth the save for that buyback. Like, the damage that they get from Sunray is just so pivotal to them having success. What else do we have up and online here? We've still been maintaining pretty good stream quality, I think. And if you guys are curious about the names of the hero portraits, those are the names of the players as well as the heroes that they are playing. Because my production value is off the charts. That's right. Twitch video shows 421 and climbing skipped frames. Yeah, there's been some issues. I'm not exactly sure what causes it, because it hasn't tended to be that much of a problem. Bottom lane still pushing in. They're not going to be able to probably take this tower from full HP because they need to come back and defend against their tier 3, but at least for now, they can keep on pushing it out with crit and then head back whenever there is an issue. So Blink on Fly, MSS, Blink Force, Glimmer Cape as well. He's pretty well situated mid lane. Yeah, just gonna clear out these illusions, push out the creep wave, and call it good. All hunky-dory for the moment. The problem is that there's not really a whole lot else for this anti-mage to grow into. And he's got almost 8,000 gold on him, but he needs to just get a moon shard, and then that's pretty much it. I don't think that you can go that much further. Probably, I mean, how much gold surplus does he have? Yeah, he definitely can go for a moon shard now if he wants. But I mean, I guess start buying tomes of experience and do they have any in stock? They don't restock in 2 minutes. Yeah, he's gonna end up going for an MKB now. Wants to be able to deal with that Ursa. And I'm assuming this is going to replace. What was that that replaces? Battle Fury? Alright, yeah, he doesn't need to farm anymore. I like that. That's a good play. He still doesn't have a moon shard, but he's more battle ready than he was previously, so that's solid. And now they're going to be going for a move. This is an important time. Like, if they can kill off the Ursa and then go for some type of counterplay and push, that's how they need to do this. And they're still, like, in a very strong power curve relative to their opponents. They just end up missing the scan of it as well. So they don't know that they're coming in from behind here. And that's going to be a jump. They catch onto Arteezy. And a lot of damage. Yawar goes forward on MG, lifted for the moment by Crit. Still keeping his buddy alive, but that should end up being a counter kill. Well, Supernova comes in, still alive. Bulma eats the cheese, and suddenly they're being able to turn this back around. A really nice Chronosphere into the egg combo, but is it actually going to end up being enough to turn it all around? Yawar still alive in the midst of all this, gets Glimmer Caped, and MSS is not going to end up being able to survive through it. Ritsu double kill already, Crit still following Yawar. They can follow this up if they so desire. Moon is going to be able to escape. I don't think they have a great way to control and kill Yawar. And now he's going to be pushing out this top lane, but with no more Battle Fury, it means the pushing is significantly slower than it was previously. A 3,000 gold swing off the back of that, and nobody from the Radiant ends up going down. This moves right into Roshan, and this is, again, starting to become more and more into the favor of the Radiant team. My goodness. Alright. Do we have a way to actually push this tower, though? That's the other big question. My god, Ritsu does so much damage! It's 400 per pop! Butterfly, E-Blade, yeah, this game is, like, just about over. Look at these towers fall! This does so much damage, and Tier 3 tower glyphed for the moment. They don't have any great way to stop this coming back, though. They do get a little bit of a counter push and play coming. Yawar ends up forcing them back for the moment. And it looks like with that, they're going to be able to get the tower down. But nothing past that. Like, the Radiant don't need to try and push this. The only way they end up losing this game is if, like, they all get caught without buyback and die. And you can see that the Radiant is really heavily prioritizing that. The only one who doesn't have it right now is Crit, who is about to be able to get it as soon as he finishes off these other creeps here. Oh my god, just kill that camp. Why are you not doing this? It makes me so sad. 322 damage. Good shiz. Alright. Arcane Rune. This helps out a good deal as well. 5,600. You know what? Okay, I was wondering if, like, Ritsu is just morphing to Agi to get himself to 322 damage. I mean, they're still definitely fighting like they want to stay in it, but it does feel very hard. There's going to need to be, like, a pretty big devastating collapse, I think, for the Radiant to not lose this game. There's ways into it and for the Dire to win it, but it's very hard. All right, what's the net worth lead? It's not really telling the whole story. The experience is much better telling the story. 25,000 lead into their favor. And it's just feeling more and more like these heroes are going to be able to do so much more with the farm that they have. Like, think about how much MG can do in these fights. You've got a Supernova save. You've also got this Sunray that does a ridiculous amount of damage that scales well into the late game. Like, all of this stuff together, as I'm starting to hear fireworks outside my house, just works so much into their favor. Well, 747 back for the moment. Level 19. I'm still waiting for their movement. At a certain point, it's like, come on, guys, just do something. Make a play. They don't want to end up losing it all to the anti-mage. But the same token, you can't play scared. You got to show these people you're not afraid to throw. Not afraid to go ham. They don't have MKB yet up for the Ursa. I don't think that they might end up going for it on the Morphling. I don't know. I feel like you just keep going stats and you just sort of survive. A Come on, folks. Make your move. Show you're not afraid. Be a true American hero like G.I. Joe. Is there anything else really to talk about here? Morphling denied the tower. That was pretty sick. I mean, if they keep on doing this, you eventually have to deal with, you know, getting a second lane of racks down. It's not insignificant. I just feel like, I don't know, maybe they're not too concerned with it about Morphling. All right, there's the jump forward, and that should be a kill on the 747. They've got eyes on him, and a couple more swipes, that's going to be a kill. Nicely played. Now Ritsu back hitting away on that ranged barracks. They've also got the damage coming out. Blinken's already popped. They can jump in if they want. BKB is out for Ritsu. Still keeping him alive. Lotus Sword on and on TZ, and they almost are going to be able to kill off. Imunus ends up going down. The Adaptive Strike swings back, but not going to be able to do enough damage. And this is where it just sort of all falls apart. 42 to 21, doubling them up in kills, 1,600 gold into their favor off of that one. But more importantly, another lane of barracks. Aegis still intact if they need to end up using it, but he's still so freaking tanky. Like, they can't really stop it. Another adaptive strike with the E-Blade, and Lion just pops. This is getting close to over. I mean, they do still have these creeps in their base. Like, if Anti-Mage ended up going for a TP Boots in, they could make that play. They're not going for it as of yet. It looks like they still want to go for the kill, and Arteezy taking a lot of your ward, dropping low. Chronosphere is going to end up getting fallen as well, and they do end up being able to get the kill. Anti-Mage buyback needs to TP into the bottom lane. Like, if they go for the tier 4s here, he could potentially win this, but I don't know. Maybe it's too scary. Like, Earth Spirit is there to be able to try and counter this out. Now with Morphling heading back, that's good game. Ends up getting called by Moon. I think that's about it. There was a chance, it would have been so hard for them to actually make that work. Ritsu just jumps back in and kills off the Earth Spirit. GG, it was a good one indeed. Oh man, what a game. What a play. What people. Let's play some more.